archipelago lured by the call of this island called Borneo. He had nothing but the clothes on his back, family in hand, a foreign tongue in his mouth, and on his head a straw hat, or so I imagined. He dedicated his life to farming, tilling the ground, sowing his seed, and from this ground is where I grew, a foreign seed in local soil, never really having a name for myself. Like I was a shade too dark to be called white. I haven't been here long enough to classify as Bumi. I'm too bad at math to call myself Chinese, and I sure as hell ain't Indian, but God, I love curry. I asked my grandmother what I should call myself. My grandmother's a storyteller. She tells me stories of the legends behind Hua Kungbu, how the designs are inspired by dreams passed down from the gods themselves, and when you think about it, Borneo is sort of like this ceremonial tapestry, how it is a kaleidoscope of cultures constantly colliding, each with their own thread, twisting and weaving itself to form our foundations, the dreams of our forefathers, delicately woven into intricate symbols and motifs, past hopes and aspirations sunk into the fabric. So sure, I may be a foreign seed, but I was grown in local soil. My roots, though young, are just as strong, intertwined like threads in Hua Kungbu. And maybe that's why people say we live in trees, because no matter where we go, we seem so close to our roots. Rivers of red running through my veins also scream, Agi idup, agi ngalaban, no retreat, no surrender. And every time I feel like I'm a weed, I remind myself I am the product of the same matrimony which birthed Sarat Laksa, Geglapis, Golokmi, and that my threads, though different, are part of this beautiful, diverse tapestry, and I guess you can call me uniquely Bornean.